Bon, d'abord, c'est un privilège.
Well, first of all, it's a real privilege to be able to share with you our vision. That's not just mine, but the vision of many people. And this is a vision that will carry us through the next 15 years so that we can have a different Canada, a Canada that will be different from the one we have today, particularly when it comes to health. We know that we have a lot of problems because health costs are now 50% of our budget. We have type 2 diabetes, and children are suffering from it as well. If we don't take care of our future generations, and these generations are people from Quebec, from they're Canadians, they're the Aboriginal people who also have their problems, we have to promote a healthy lifestyle. And I think, in fact, Aboriginal people have even more problems with that. So it is our duty as a society to create programs and projects that bring us together. I agree with culture, yes, but the Quebec culture is different from the one, the Canadian culture, and different from the one of the Aboriginal people. And I do think that shows and so on do bring them together. But health is essential. Health is essential for everyone, whether you're white, black, Aboriginal, or other. Everybody is concerned about living a healthy life. And for us adults, we want our children to grow without health problems. For many years, we've been celebrating the different anniversaries in my region, the 175th, the 150th, the 375th anniversary. I hope that one day we are going to celebrate an anniversary on human health, because right now there's a huge challenge over the next 10 years in most of the industrialized worlds and many of the other countries as well. Health costs are actually creating a major problem, and they're causing us to cut the budget elsewhere, such as in schools, in knowledge, in industries, in technology, because we need to now go on campaigns to actually increase research and innovation, and also to make sure that we have an expectation of life. You know that expectation of life is now 75 for men, 85 for women, and we are absolutely not able to actually change the quality of life for Quebec and Canada because of the people who have the wrong lifestyles. And wrong lifestyles, 80% of Canadians suffer from that. So life expectancy has to be increased. And if we do not do that, we're going to continue increasing our health costs. In Quebec now, we know that 50% of our taxes go to the health care. And actually, they are only helping with the symptoms and with curing people, but not with research and prevention. And we have diabetes too at age 12 now. We have children suffering from that, and of course they're going to have a lower life expectancy than we have. These are our children in Quebec, in Canada. The communities are concerned about their children. 50% of these people are less than 25 years old with diabetes type 2. And when you don't listen to them, and they're a minority, it is not easy for them. So how do we get everybody to back up this ideology so that we can really change our culture? How do we change the health culture? Obviously, by the decision makers. They have the power over the next few years. They're the ones who do our urban planning. They're the ones who deal with our educational budgets and how much sport we offer and so on and so forth. You know, we have to deal with that. I think that the future of Canada in 2017 should be one in which we're going to have a very big national celebration, but we have to take concrete steps to improve the health of our society, because otherwise we'll be judged later. And when they become sick, they're going to blame our generation because we did nothing. In Quebec and Canada, we talk, we criticize, but we do nothing. We're expecting the state to take everything in hand and deal with this. Well, the governments in the states are already investing 50% of our taxes in health. And obviously, we need to get into prevention. And you know, we cut education by $500,000 in Quebec. Nobody criticized, nobody said anything. We are going to have health problems in the future, social economic problems in the future, because we're neglecting education. Are we doing everything that we can in Quebec and Canada to really help those little trees that we're planting to really grow straight? Are we watering them every day? This is what we need to do. If nobody takes care of them, you know, I live in the forest area. If you don't take care of that tree that is actually in a disadvantaged soil, well, what is going to happen? It is going to grow crooked, and that is what will happen. Today is the day we have to take action. We still have time to prepare a celebration for 2017 that's going to bring all Canadians together. B-Day, Aboriginal, Black, White, Canadian, Quebecois. But people should actually improve life expectancy and the quality of life so that we have a margin to maneuver for everything else, because culture is still going to get cut back, because obviously we have to make difficult choices. And the government is just going to put the money in the priority, and that's going to be health. Because the people are saying, don't touch health. Any government that touches health will not be reelected. Let's change our way of looking at things so that our leaders will have the capacity and the courage to actually take the gestures and make the gestures we need. You know? We have to demand what we want. They do all these surveys about what Canadians want and what the Quebec people want, and then they want to be re-elected, so they're going to align themselves to what we want. So let us express what we want. Let us work with our communities, with the children. I'm going to show you a little video. This video is going to show you the big challenge that we have. It's a program that goes around Quebec. We created a caravan that cost $1 million. We visit hundreds of schools across Canada, visit every province and all the regions of Canada. This program has been spread out throughout Canada. All the provinces are doing it, and we are right in the middle of it. And I'm sure there are people who are hearing about their children talking about the energy promotion to go out and bike and do this and do that. Well, that is exactly what we're doing. We're trying to take care of that tree and watering it. Our school teachers are doing their job. They just need our encouragement and our support. So in 2017, I hope that we're going to be able to get everyone together around health, that we have all kinds of festivals, activities, demonstrations, dealing with human beings and their health. We should be dealing with our health first, because we need our health to do anything, and we and our health system and our government needs us to focus on health. And our first and foremost responsibility as an adult is to teach our children so that they have a different mindset compared to the adults of today. The cardiologists have been telling us, everyone has been telling us, stop talking and do something. This is a historical moment in Canada, and 2017 will also be a landmark for Montreal. I know that people here are already planning the 375th anniversary in Montreal. I have lots of ideas so that we can focus on health. We're not the only people who have a problem with the health